Before I get into a discussion of these two paintings, which you see, I would actually like to quote an art critic from New York named Garrett Henry, who said this about these paintings. He had been aware of my 2 years of study in Florence, where I was doing conceptual painting, art history paintings, and very serious historical kind of paintings. His quote is, "Kelley found himself exhausted by the influences pieces and all the research and studying and self-searching he had done to bring it about. So he began traveling to villages large and small near Florence, intent on relaxing by working and getting down to the sites and sites, S-I-T-E-S, of his personal paradises in his own painterly style. The results are landscapes loaded with primitivistic charm and bucolic beauty. Nipozano and Tranquillo are two views from the winemaking Frescobaldi family castle. The former is rigorous in patent application and hue, while the latter features a softer, simpler handling." I feel that this is a perfect introduction to the landscape paintings, which from 2001 until this current year, 2020, I've been doing. And let's just start at the beginning, and we'll start with Nipozano. This is, again, a massive mural-sized painting, which is 60 by 72 inches. That's 5 by 6 feet. And it is a view of the Frescobaldi wine estate that is called Nipozano. Following my studies in December of 2000, we were guests of the Frescobaldis at an engagement party for one of their nephews. We spent the whole day there. We went with friends from Florence, Lisa and Marcello, who actually were the ones that introduced us to the Frescobaldis. And it was just an incredibly beautiful day. I had a sketchbook, again, but I didn't really use it because it didn't seem appropriate with all the people around. However, on the way home, I asked the person driving if he could just pull over because I saw this vista. And I took several photographs and did a couple of quick compositional sketches. From this, I began the painting in my new studio in Florence. It's a studio that I had over by the Church of San Marco. And it was my first personal studio after 2 semesters of studying at the school. So this painting was compositionally fairly realistic, and I was trying to achieve that. But there is so much in it, and it was really an immersion, a total immersion into the Tuscan landscape. And you can see everything about this is Tuscany. The cypress trees, the olive trees, the golden fields, the way the trees are lined up symmetrically. This is just one beautiful area of Italy. And I think the simplicity of the castle in the background goes very, very well with the colors and the contours of the painting. Again, it was the fall, so the colors are more autumn-like, and particularly in the golds and the reds of the fields. I paint differently with the colors in the cypress trees. As you see, this when I first started mixing, there's some over to the right, there's blue trees, but for the most part they're the dark green, the gold in the background of the autumn trees, and again the time, the olive trees over on the right side were more silver colored, silver blue. So again, this painting was the first landscape that I did in Florence. And subsequently, I displayed it at an art exhibition in, it was an international art exhibition in Palm Springs, California. And the painting was purchased by Mr. and Mrs. Michael Dunaway of San Diego, California. Okay, now the second painting is called Tranquillo. Again, it's a 5 by 6 foot large canvas and painted from the same day that I was at the Frescobaldi Wine Estate. It is, or as Garrett Henry said, but it's a much simpler and softer approach to painting. This is a view, whereas the Nipozano is a view of the castle, this is a view from the, one of the views from the castles looking off into the hills, and actually one of the caretaker's houses off in the fields. Now, this painting, I did know it at the time when I started it at my San Marco studio, but this was going to make a seismic change in my life. And as I said, I'll talk about that a little later, but when I was painting it, I had no clue. I was just working and experimenting in a lot of different colors. And I have to say, to back up a little, when I had the studio, my teachers from the Medici Institute had left the school, and they were doing part-time consultants. So I had an agreement with them that they would come to my studio once every 2 weeks and give me a critique for which I would pay them, as long as they didn't, you know, say anything about what I was painting. And the very reason I say that, this painting, these olive trees, I painted them towards the end of the painting, and I was getting, you know, a little bored. I'd really achieved what I wanted with the background, because I really got those flesh tone. I think I really killed it with the flesh tone hills in the background and the soft purples and the sky and the green and the cypress trees and the olive trees in the background. And but one of the teachers, Claire, suggested instead of doing detail olive trees, she recommended I buy this certain pointed brush and do these flick strokes. And that's exactly what they are. So instead of being bored by doing the final application, all these little trees was, you know, I can show you, they're like three strokes. One, two, three. One, two, three. And I got the shadows in, I got everything, and it was, I mean, it was a great little exercise for me. So subsequently to painting the painting in 2001 at my San Marco studio, I shipped it to the States, and I had a show in New York City at the Walter Wickizer Gallery in 2002. It was actually my second show there, but this was the first one to feature primarily Italian scenes. And Walter and I put an ad in Art News magazine, and the ad was a photo of this particular painting, Tranquillo. And lo and behold, one day, it was ironic because it was the day that Garrett Henry was there reviewing my work, who was a New York art critic writing for Art News. Walter got some mail, and one of them was a postcard, which I have here, because you have to see this. And the postcard almost looks like it's written in Arabic. But if you can decipher it, it says, first of all, it says it's from Sister Wendy, Carmelite Monastery, Quindendam, Norwich. Sister Wendy, I'm sure a lot of you know, was probably one of the most respected art historians and authors. She was a cloistered nun, but spent probably a month a year going to museums all over the world. She started doing it in England at the National Museum and the Tate Museum, but then continued with work in the United States. And she would do videos and write books about the museums. Arguably, in some circles, the top art historian on the planet. So now we get this card and we decipher it. And what it says, again, it's, I would be interested to see more of William Kelley's work. It seems to have a lyric strength that is very moving. The funny thing is, Garrett Henry, who was a very well-respected critic, was in awe of this, and he said to Walter, and Walter wasn't sure who she was, and I remember Garrett sitting there, and he said, Walter, tell me what you think about me. And Walter said, well, I think you're one of the best, if not the best critic in New York City. And then Garrett, just big smile, he said, well, think world. So again, this was a seismic change. Garrett looked at me and he said, you should write something to this woman and show, obviously send her a book that we had just produced for the show. And again, that was 2002. And as we go into future paintings here, I will tell you the influence that Sister Wendy had on my art career, which was sizable. Because once I got the imprimatur from her, everybody in the art world knows it was about her, just her love for the work, as we'll see down the road with her other quotes, and had nothing to do with money. And I did not seek her. She actually sought out my work, which was unheard of in the business of art. Critics, you know, they get paid to do stuff. And at any rate, it was the beginning of a wonderful relationship, and also the impact. I just can't tell you how important it was. And this particular painting was subsequently purchased by a good friend and collector, Dr. Murph Klauber, who was the owner of the Colony Tennis and Beach Resort in Sarasota, Florida, one of the most legendary places for tennis and beach, one of the top in the world at the time. As a follow-up, I'd just like to say that we did send Sister Wendy Beckett, we being Walter Wickage and I, and we took the advice of Garrett Henry and sent her a book of all the paintings that were in the show that she had requested. And in response, she sent a postcard to the gallery, to me personally, and this was what she said about the paintings in the book that included the painting Tranquil. She said, and I quote, "You create a world of the soft line, color, and shape I see here in my solitude. A healing world. What greater praise? And a point is not in any escapist or, quote, pretty, unquote. No, it is as profound a vision as one could want." Sister Wendy Beckett, April 2003. Now that made me feel very good. That's quite a quote. As profound a vision as one could want. Thank you, Sister Wendy.